How you doing, guys? First and foremost, my name's Sheldon, and I'm just gonna start making car videos basically to appeal to anybody who has an interest in cars and kind of wants to watch. Excuse the accent; you might get used to it over time, or you might hate it, and you might not watch me. But hopefully, you'll like it, and hopefully, you can tolerate it. I suppose I could show you the cars: a black Subaru Impreza. Blob Eye, 2006, don't mind the wheels are, I have wheels that I want to get for it, they're just, they're not the wheels for it, but I've swapped in a EJ207 out of an earlier model Impreza. The reason why I did this was because they're a closed deck block. I've still got some wires to extend and my front mount to finish off and my intercooler piping out to finish off, but at the moment, that's the way she stands. She has a roll cage, half roll cage in her at the minute. I have to finish the roll cage, but there'll be videos coming and all that, and then we have to drill it in. We have to get the mounting plates for the bottom. It's a bolt-in cage, so I can show you guys how to mount that. I also have a 200 SX S14. I absolutely love this car. I've always wanted one of them, and then I finally found the money to finally go purchase one over the summer. And then I have my daily driver, which is a 2002 Subaru Forester S Turbo. I absolutely love this car. I never thought I would. The way I acquired this car was out of a swap, and technically your man paid me to take the car in the blown second gear, and I actually had a gearbox from a classic STI. So now she has an STI gearbox, STI diff in her, and then over time she came with a TDR3 and it's been upgraded. I'll go more into depth than that. She's just been washed, so basically I just want to kind of make this startup video about how I'm gonna basically wax this car. So I'm gonna set you guys up for a time lapse, and then I'm gonna show you how to go about waxing the car. Now, the stuff I'm gonna be using to wax the car is my own special concoction. It is this Demon Shine, but it's not totally Demon Shine. Some of the stuff in this is Demon Shine spray on wax. It has Turtle Wax spray on wax. I have a little bit of shampoo wax in it as well. I thought while we're here, I might as well show you how I'm going to wax the car. I've just explained to you what I'm using, but I'm not actually explaining to you how I'm going to do it. Now, I've had success with this. I use it for my daily driver because my other two cars get polished on a regular basis. This car, I use every day. There's no point polishing it and then washing it every weekend and then polishing it again. I wax it, it lasts the whole week, and then literally de-wax it and then rinse it and then wash it again and then wax it again. But basically what I'm going to be using is microfibers. Now, I have all different types of microfibers. I have about three or four. Each one of them has a specifically different purpose. Now, one will be for wax on, one will be for wax off, one will be for wheels, one will be for tires, and one will be for trim. The reason why you do this is because for some chemicals that I'm using, for example, trim is only for black, back to black. You don't want to spray back to black on your paint because it'll just go like a milky color. Trust me, I've had it.
Second, let me catch my breath. Remind me how it feels to hear your voice. Your lips are moving, I can hear a thing. Living life as if we had a choice. Anywhere, anytime, I would do anything for you.
If you can see here, I can't really get it on the camera just yet. I'm trying to find a spot where we can pick up where there's like a bit of a kind of like a when you wipe a window and it leaves a residue on a window. Now we can't actually pick this up just yet. There, you guys can just see that right there. See the way it kind of leaves like a smear mark. Well, the next step now is to go again with a clean rag and wipe that off again. I'll set you guys up for the second time lapse, and then I'll wipe it off and I'll show you the finished product on the body, and then we'll go and move ahead to the windows and the wheels. And that's more or less how I wax my car. Now, I'm not going out preaching how everyone should wax their car. That is just how I wax my car. Hopefully it will help some people to figure out how they should wax the car. Because I know when I've gone to shows, people ask me, how do you get the car the way it is with such minimal effort? I just say, just a quick wax. I show them the little tips and tricks what I use, and they seem to be happy enough with it. Now, I know I'm not a detailer by any means. Just like having a clean car, I like going to a few cruises. I like to have my car looking half decent. I'll just show you the finished product. So, as you can see, it looks alright. Now, it's not a 1,000,000%. There is some imperfections, like right here, where the previous owner got a ding in the wing that he tried to repair. But as you can see, it's decent enough where you can see the reflection of the stuff and the wall and the floor. So it's not a 100% bad, but I wouldn't say it is a million times as good as a polishing gun can get now. But it'll do the job. It'll keep the car clean for the next week at least while it's travelled in and out to work, working back. And living in Ireland, it rains a lot, so it keeps a lot of the dirt off. And now the next step is the wheels. And as I said, every rag has a different purpose. Now, what I did there, I took the same wax that I waxed the car with, and I just wiped down the wheels with it. The reason for that is because it provides some lubrication. As I said, there's soap in here, provides some lubrication for getting the grime and the dirt off. And I'm thinking the theory behind it is that being wax, it will also stop any dirt sticking. Now, these alloys are actually really good. I have had XXRs, and I've had rotor grids, and I've had some work wheels, and everything with a very small spoke of a wheel seems to get dirt a lot stuck in here. Now, these wheels aren't that bad, but they do get a bit of dirt stuck in here, and ever since I started doing this, a lot less dirt has started gathering in the little crevices here, which helps, of course, when you're cleaning it. Now, the next step is to grab the tire dressing. I'll show you which tire dressing I like to use, and I'll explain why I like to use it. Now, this is not a paid promotion or anything. I just like to use the Demon Tire tire dressing. The reason for this is because it is so simple to use, and it actually does the job well when it's been put on correctly. It doesn't just wash off, like I've had other brands just wash off, more expensive brands just wash off. This cost me, I think it's €5. It lasts me about 4 weeks, and it does the job outstandingly. It's very easy to apply. It's just and then grab a different rag. And that's it. I'm going to finish off this and then I'll get back to you guys. Nobody by my side. Alright guys, well now that's the wheels done. Now the next thing that I want to tackle is the glass. I cannot stand during glass, it's just a pain. But I found this really easy way, it doesn't take too long. It's about using the right materials, the right stuff, and just spray it on. Spray it, not too much. What I was doing before was I was spraying it too much, the rag was getting too wet, and it was just leaving streak marks everywhere. So I'll show you what I do now, and it seems to work brilliantly. Now I've already done the front window, so I'm not going to do the front window again. Front window doesn't need to be done, but I'll be doing the three side windows where I'm going to be leaving for a time lapse, and I'll show you guys the result. What I'm going to be using is bog standard, just window glass cleaner. Doesn't need to be doing anything special, doesn't need to be specifically for cars, any window glass cleaner will work. And remember, a new rag, every rag has its own purpose. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to spray it on the rag and not on the window. When it's on the rag, I'm just going to quickly glide, and then wipe it off, and then that should be it done. I'll do it on these two windows here to show you what I mean, and there you go. Now I'm finished with the windows, I'll show you the result, let's see what you think. Now it's not perfect because I didn't really put 100% effort into it, it is getting late, and as I said, this is just a quick clean of the car just to get ready for the next week. I'm going to tackle the other side and then we'll do a quick beauty shot of the Well guys, that's the end of my video. That's an introduction to myself, an introduction to what I want to do, and an introduction to, I suppose, how I wax my car. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like, comment, subscribe. I'd love any feedback, even if you're just watching the video passing by. Just give it a quick, you are shit, or you need to improve on this, or you need to improve on that. Any criticism is creative criticism, as I see it. So, yeah, thank you very much for watching. Peace out.